the fever area was set up during the first few days of the SARS outbreak 10 years ago. And when we decided that we needed to have a separate area to assess and manage fever patients, we sat with our engineers and identified the area within the emergency department which was to be the fever area. Having identified the area, the engineers went about doing the hoarding to isolate this area. And after that, the air conditioning system was isolated. Extractor fans were installed in every one of the consultation rooms in the identified fever area during SARS. We worked in those areas for the first few months of the SARS outbreak. Gradually, we introduced air conditioning and a new ventilation system into that fever area, which was separate from the ventilation system used for the rest of the hospital. In this new ventilation system, the air that was brought into the fever area was fresh air, and after the air was managed and mixed with the patient's and staff's own air, it was extracted from the department to the external atmosphere. But before that, it was cleaned through a process of using filters and also radiating that air with UV light. After the SARS outbreak, we went about planning for a new, properly structured fever area. We did not have time for such new construction during the SARS outbreak because of the immediacy of the situation then. But following the SARS outbreak, a new fever area was designed in the very same area that we used during SARS. And this fever area included an anteroom to serve as a buffer between the normal areas of the department and the fever area. It also included facilities for managing trolley patients, and an observation ward was also included within the fever area. Toilets and X-ray facilities were also placed in this fever isolation area within the emergency department. All these ensured that potential patients with potentially infectious diseases coming to the emergency department could be managed safely and in comfortable surroundings and in safe surroundings while they were in the emergency department. Today too, these facilities are being used. Whenever a patient comes to the emergency department, they go through an initial fever screening. In the fever screening, they are first asked questions as to whether they have fevers, cough, and the symptoms of common infections. They also asked about their travel history, whether they have been to any of those areas in the world which currently do have an outbreak of an infectious illness, or whether they have contact with infectious patients. If any of these were present, then they would be sent to the fever area. They'd be isolated immediately. There they'd be assessed by a team of staff who are already wearing some form of personal protective equipment. If the need arises, these staff could also don additional protective gear, such as full-length gowns, such as visors, such as N95 masks. If they require admission into the hospital to an isolation unit from the fever area, they can be moved to the isolation unit by staff who are specially protected to ensure that the chances of infection being transmitted are minimized. In addition to all these, we have also instituted other practices in the department, for example, hand washing. So today, before any member of the staff sees a patient, they would either wash their hands or they would rub their hands with alcohol. And after having examined the patients, before they would move to another patient or touch the computer to enter their clinical notes, they'd again rub their hands with alcohol. And all this ensures that we minimize the chances of infection being transmitted from one person to the other within the hospital environment. Today, we are much more prepared than we were prior to SARS because we have in place as routine the system of fever screening. Number two, today everyone is aware about the need to minimize transmission of infections.